Hey everyone, welcome to the Bruce Williams channel. We're going to talk about an exciting announcement that Breitling just dropped on us today. They've announced their 2020 releases, and there's some really cool heritage-inspired models. And I think it's a really wise move on Breitling's part to take the time to dominate the news cycle today with their watches. A lot of brands are just pushing out their announcements indefinitely, but not Breitling, and I think that's an awesome move, and it's a nice break from the current news cycle, and we get to kind of geek out a little bit about some fun upcoming watches. And the one I want to talk about to you with you today is from their capsule collection. This is the Breitling Super Ocean Heritage 1957, and it might be a little bold. I know when I first saw it, I'm like, wow, they really went all out with this Heritage Edition, but the more I look at it, the more I'm excited about it. And the things that I'm noticing, I'm really digging. So let's kind of dive in a little bit. This is a 42 millimeter diameter watch. The great thing is 10 millimeters in height, so super thin, and I think it's gonna be very wearable. If we take a look at the case shape, we can see arcing lugs that sweep down. Most of the width of this piece is coming from that big concave or angled a ceramic bezel that if we turn the watch over on the rose tone version, the gold bezel, you can see just how much that bezel adds to the overall width. So I think this is gonna wear very nicely with the shape, with the thinness, and the fact that if you look at the face of the watch, proportionally, we're getting big markers, a relatively small dial surface area in this dominant bezel. So I think it's gonna look awesome and be very comfortable. Now, this does not have the Tudor in-house movement that they're putting in the Breitling Super Ocean Heritage. Now, I've owned that watch. I own the 44 version blue on the mesh, and I really enjoyed the watch. It's beautiful. It's well done, but it's a thick boy. That Tudor in-house movement, it's thick. So the fact that this one is more stylistically taking cues from that original Super Ocean from 1957, and it's thinner, I just think this is a recipe for success. Now, Breitling has said that this is not a limited edition, but they're not gonna produce it indefinitely alongside of their Super Ocean Heritage that we know right now. So how long are they gonna make it? I have no idea. It could not sell very well, and they'll only make it for, what, 6 months? It could be super popular, and maybe it even replaces the current Super Ocean Heritage line. We have no way of knowing, but I'm very optimistic about this release. So this, again, does not carry the Tudor in-house movement. What it is the Breitling Caliber 10, which is a modified ETA 2892 that does not have the date feature. So that's going to help bring what's already a thin caliber even thinner. And I think that's a great move because, again, the original Super Ocean from 1957 did not have a date. So I think that's a wise move. The bezel, the ceramic bezel, is bi-directional rotating, which is awesome. Again, it's like that original release from 1957. So I'm looking forward to this. What would be any negative aspects? Right off the bat, as I'm looking at the watch, I've noticed that the crown is not a screw-in crown. This does carry 100 meters of water resistance. There are two different gaskets in the crown, but it is a push-pull crown. And some of you may really be offended by that. And I was disappointed at first, but as I've thought about it, the screw-in feature really only is to lock the crown in place so it doesn't become dislodged as you're diving or using the watch underwater. The whole water resistance comes from the closure of the crown and the gaskets, the seals, the two gaskets in the case of the Super Ocean Heritage 1957. So could you dive with this recreational scuba diving? You could. Would I recommend it? I don't know. I'd probably wear one of my Seikos. I've got a Seiko Sumo on today if I was going to be scuba diving recreationally. If you're a pro saturation diver, definitely no. Definitely not. But you already knew that. So that's really the only thing that kind of gives me reservation. But the more I've thought about it, the more I've looked at the case shape and specifically the bezel, how it comes out past the case. And I think it would be a little bit difficult to screw or unthread or thread the crown with that dominant bezel and the thin profile. So maybe there is some really thinking that issue through on the part of Breitling, their design team, and that's why it's push-pull. So let me go through the versions and colors here. I've written them down. Black and blue, on mesh, fitted mesh, I might add, 4825 retail. I think that's great. On leather, $43.80, so about a $500 difference there. Two-tone, $52.25 on leather. Hey, check this one out. The Rainbow Limited Edition, 250 units worldwide, boutique exclusive. When I first saw this, I thought it was just silly looking, but the more I look at it, man, the more I think it's really, really cool, and I kind of prefer it over the other ones, as crazy as that sounds. This one retails for $5,025. Now, I've got to give Breitling some respect and props right here for this, right? When you come out with a limited edition, it's truly limited. They didn't go with the Omega route, and they're not producing 7,794 watches, right? 250 worldwide, that's a small number. Those things are gonna sell out quickly, even with a bold, but really bold look that's kind of out there. They're gonna sell out quickly. The fact that it's truly limited and they didn't decide to upcharge by $3,000 or $5,000, it's a difference of about $200 from the regular black version. So man, more brands need to follow in Breitling's footsteps with a few aspects, with coming out with true limited editions that are not super premium. And when you're coming out with a heritage model, man, go all out. Go really all out and match that original design and the elements that made it popular and beloved in the eyes of us crazy watch fans. And also one last thing, hey, when we're hungry for good news as a community, a watch community right now, take the time, dominate the news cycle with your upcoming releases. So I'm talking to you, Rolex and Tudor and Patek and Omega. I wanna see what you have to offer us here in the coming year. So guys, what do you think of Breitling's new announcement today? I think the Chronomat in copper looks awesome. The new Zorro looks great. Again, this Rainbow Super Ocean Heritage 1957 from the Capsule Collection has really got my eye. And maybe I'll reach out to a couple of my Breitling buddies and we'll share the watch, right? We'll all buy it, we'll all go in together and buy it and try it out. We'll see what happens. I'm looking forward to it. I'll also reach out to my my Breitling contact at Saltzman's, my Breitling authorized dealer that I get to borrow watches from, and see the timeline of when these are released, maybe the possible discounts that can be had, and I'll share that information with you guys for those that are interested. I know not all of you are gonna be as excited about this announcement as me, but I think it's exciting, and I'm looking forward to it. Looking forward to seeing more, seeing real world pictures, and guys, let me know what you think in the comments section. So until next time, thanks for watching.